Hello dear students and welcome back in our biology session. So as we know, we are discussing our lesson, that is what? Cell. So in this cell lesson already we have discussed some points, and in the last video we have discussed about the parts of a cell. So basically there are the three main parts present in the cell, that are cell membrane, cytoplasm and also what? Nucleus. Okay, so these are the three main parts, or we can say that these are the three basic parts which are present in each and every cell. But now we will discuss that nucleus. Already we have discussed about the nucleus. Nucleus is what? The central spherical structure present in the cell, which is called as what? Nucleus. Okay. In the plant cell, it is present at the periphery, while in the animal cell, it is present in the center of the cell. Okay. So this is all about nucleus we have discussed, but again now we will discuss about the nucleus deeply. There are the certain other parts of the nucleus. So the nucleus mainly consists the four parts, that are nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, nucleolus and chromosomes. Okay, so with all these things, all these four substances, the nucleus are get made. So the nucleus consists the four main parts, that are, which are the parts, that are nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, nucleolus and chromosomes. Okay, so let's discuss all these four parts one by one deeply. First we will start with the nuclear membrane. Okay, so now what is meant by the nuclear membrane? So the nuclear membrane is the membrane which separates the nucleus from the cytoplasm. Okay, so see here, this is cytoplasm, this is cell membrane, and as we know, inside the cell, in the center of the cell, if it is an animal cell, then the spherical structure is present, which is called as what? Nucleus. So this nucleus again is having one more membrane, and with the help of that membrane, the nucleus are get separate. That means we can come to know this is the nucleus. It doesn't get mixed into the cytoplasm with the help of this nuclear membrane. Okay, so the nuclear membrane is the membrane which separates the nucleus from the cytoplasm. Okay, like cell membrane, as we have discussed in the cell membrane is a porous. They are having the small holes on it. Okay, so like that cell membrane, this nuclear membrane is also having the small holes on it, which allows the entry for the selected substances. Okay, only selected substances can get enter into the nucleus. Okay, so this is all about what? Nuclear membrane, which separates the nucleus from cytoplasm. Okay, clear here? This nuclear membrane is again having the small holes or pores which allow the entry only for the selected substance. Next one we will discuss, that inside this nuclear membrane there is a fluid substance is present. Okay, inside the nuclear membrane there is a fluid color thick substance is present, and that substance is called as what? Nucleoplasm. Okay, that substance is called as what? Nucleoplasm. See, in the cell there is what? Cytoplasm. There is what? Cytoplasm. Also in the cell there is a nucleus, and inside the nucleus there is a fluid substance present, and that fluid substance is called as what? Nucleoplasm. Plasm is seen as in the liquid state, we can say like that. So it is present in the nucleus, that's why it is called as what? Nucleoplasm. So this is about what? Nuclear membrane and the nucleoplasm. Also inside the nucleoplasm, or in the nucleoplasm, there are the small spherical structures are present. Okay, in the nucleoplasm there are the small spherical structure is present, and that small spherical structures are called as nucleolus. Okay, it is called as what? Nucleolus. Dear student, don't get confused over here. Very easy, if you learn properly, if you listen properly what I am telling, it is very easy to keep in the mind. Now we are discussing the parts of nucleus. Nucleus is also having one membrane which is called as what? Nuclear membrane. Okay, nucleus also having the fluid substance, and that fluid substance is called as what? Nucleoplasm. that nucleoplasm contains a small spherical structure, and that small spherical structure are called as what? Nucleolus. Okay, that small spherical structures are called as nucleolus. Okay, so up till now we have discussed about nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm and nucleolus. Okay, and these nucleolus are rich in RNA. Now what is mean by RNA? So these nucleolus are rich in RNA. Now RNA is what? Ribonucleic acid. RNA is what? Ribonucleic acid. R stands for ribo, R N stands for nucleic, and A stands for acid, ribonucleic acid. So these are the acids which are present in the nucleolus. Okay, and that acid name is what? Ribonucleic acid, and the short form is what? RNA. Okay, so this is about what? Nucleolus. Now we'll move for the next and the important part of the nucleus, that is nothing but what? Chromosomes. Okay, now what is mean by chromosomes? Let's discuss about the chromosomes. So let's discuss about the chromosome. So some fine thread like structure, okay, see here I will draw some fine, very fine thin thread like structures are suspended into the nucleoplasm, are present in the nucleoplasm, which is composed of, which is made up of DNA. They are made up of what? DNA. Now what is mean by DNA? DNA is what? Deoxyribonucleic acid. As we know, acid A stands for acid, D stands for deoxyribo, deoxyribo, and N stands for what? Nucleic. Okay, like that. Deoxyribonucleic acid, that is also the one form of the acid which form or which is get into these fine thread like structures. Okay, and then fine thread like structure which are composed of, which are made up of DNA, are called as chromatin fiber, are called as what? Chromatin fibers. Okay, so again I will repeat, in the nucleoplasm there are the small fine thread like structures are present which are made up of DNA. DNA is what? Deoxyribonucleic acid, and that substances which are presented in the nucleoplasm which are thread like and made up of DNA, that substances are called as what? Chromatin fibers. Okay, they are called as what? Chromatin fibers. So during the dividing of nucleus, okay, for the reproduction you can say that the nucleus get divide. Okay, so for the dividing of the nucleus, or during the nucleus is getting divided, these chromatin fibers get condensed. Okay, get condensed, and that condensed chromatin fibers are only called as what? Chromosomes. That condensed means what? We can say the shrink somehow. They get shrink somehow during the nucleus dividation. Okay, when the nucleus is dividing, that time what happen? These fibers are getting condensed, and then that fibers are called as what? Chromosomes. And that is the reason these chromosomes are only visible when the nucleus is dividing. Okay, when the nucleus is dividing, that time only we can see these chromosomes. Okay, up till now clear here, dear students? Chromosomes means what? These fine thread like structures are get condensed during the nucleus dividation, and then it forms the chromosomes. And very important, these chromosomes contain the genes. Okay, these chromosomes contains the genes. Okay, now what is mean by gene? Okay, now what is mean by the gene? Gene is the unit of inheritance. I will write here. What is mean by gene? Gene is a unit of inheritance. Okay, what is mean by the gene? Gene is called as what? Unit of inheritance. Now what is mean by inheritance? What is mean by hereditary? Okay, let's discuss about that. So, just now we have said that what? The gene is a unit of inheritance in a living organisms. Okay, so with the help of the gene, some characters are getting passed from the parents to the child. Okay, so the genes is responsible for the passing the characters from parents to the offspring. Now, what is mean by the characters? I will give you one example. So, see, if your parents, we are telling that all the people, those who are watching us, observing us, they are telling us, you look like your father, you look like your mother, your hairs are like your mother, your nose is like your father, your eyes are like your father. Like that, they are telling us, they are giving us comments. So, how it is possible? Because with the help of this gene, some characters which pass from the parents to the offspring. Okay, there are the certain characters which comes from our parents to us with the help of these genes, and that is the reason the genes are called as unit of inheritance in living organisms. Okay, so this is all about what nucleus. These are the four main parts of the nucleus. That is what nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, nucleolus, and chromosomes. Okay, now we'll discuss the functions of the nucleus. So, as we know, this nucleus is the main part in the cell. It controls all the activity of the cell. Okay, it controls all whatever the activities are going on in the cell, all get under control of the nucleus. It controls all the different activities which takes place in the cell. Also, it passes the genetic characters from the parents to the offspring. Why? Because as we know, in the nucleus there are the chromatin fibers, which we are calling as what? Chromosomes. And in that chromosomes, it contains the genes, and the genes helps to response or to transfer the characters from the parents to the offspring. Okay, so see, for example, again I will tell, if your father is having the black eyes or the gray eyes, then it is possibility is that the newborn of that same parents been having the grey eyes. If your mother is having the curly hair, then it is the possibility that you will also get the curly hair. That boy or the girl of that which born from that same lady will get the curly hairs also. Okay, so these are the certain characters that get passed from the parents to the offspring. Okay, and with the help of this gene. Okay, so this is all about, right? This is all about what? Nucleus, nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, nucleolus, and the chromosomes are the, all these are the four main parts of the nucleus. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.